Recall that the power in a computing system has, roughly speaking, two parts. The first is constant power, which is what you pay just to keep the system on. The other part is dynamic power. That's what you pay above and beyond constant power while the program is running. Let's take a quick look at some of the basic Circuits 101 drivers that underlie dynamic power. Imagine a simple logic gate taken out of a larger circuit. This gate has a certain amount of physical energy. It is both right and natural to represent that energy by analogy to a snifter of mighty fine Atlanta-based beverage. Quick extra credit if you can name this brewery. Now suppose a gate input changes. Then the energy dissipates and also quite naturally has to be refilled. Put differently, when the circuit switches, there will be some energy loss. This energy loss then has to be restored. Let's first ask how much energy that is and then ask how frequently this switching happens. Let's see how to compute dynamic power. Start with the amount of energy consumed by this gate during a state change. In electrical engineering terms, C is the gate's capacitance. Capacitance is a function of the material properties and geometry of the gate. V is the supply voltage. Supply voltage is part of the circuit design. It can, for some circuits, be tuned over some range. More importantly is how V enters into the equation. It enters as the square. Now, for our class, it's not too important to understand exactly where this relationship comes from. But do remember that the product CV squared quantifies energy. So how often does switching happen? Well, there are two factors. The first is the frequency or clock rate of the circuit. It has units of cycles per unit time. The clock rate determines the maximum number of times that the circuit can switch or change states per unit time. Now, the gate doesn't necessarily switch on every cycle. Depending on what the computation is doing, the switches might happen only once every few cycles. That brings us to the second factor, which is the activity factor. It's the number of switches per cycle. If you think about how a clock works, it has a maximum value of 1. In general, it will depend on what the computation is doing. Taken together, these parameters tell us how to compute dynamic power. It's basically the energy per gate, or CV squared, times the switching frequency, which is A times F. This formula is sometimes called the dynamic power equation. Before moving on, let me give you one more quick fact about it. The clock rate F and the supply voltage V usually need to be kept in proportion to one another. That is, suppose you cut F in half, then you also need to cut V in half. Increases are the same. Suppose you increase F by 2, then you also need to double V. So why do F and V need to change together? The short story is that it has to do with maintaining the stability and reliability of the circuit. In particular, its reliability in the presence of environmental noise. Okay, now is a good time to pause and see if you can understand what this formula implies can be done if you want to increase performance while reducing power.